Jess is back to share more about his trip to the summit of Mauna Kea.
You know how technology is so quickly evolving, cell phones, computers? Oh, yeah. Same thing with telescopes, right? Subu telescope, not just making amazing discoveries right now, but for the next generation, imagine what they'll be able to see, so much more than what we can see today. The Subaru telescope marks 20 years of discovery and inspiration atop Mauna Kea. There's more than just reflective mirrors that peer into the clear night sky. Subaru telescope is about a contribution to education, to inspire the next generation to explore space in the same way that mankind has always done from the beginning of time, by looking into the night sky.
What kind of people work for the Subaru telescope?
So we have about 92 people working here at Subaru telescope, and about 30 employed by Japanese government, and the rest are locally hired.
And it's people from all walks of life.
This is not all scientists who work here. There are many technicians, engineers, and administrators.
Work at Subaru is not only done at night. Images are analyzed and perfected day and night, and the people work around the clock.
What do you think is the biggest challenge in maintaining this telescope?
People working here are always challenging with high altitude, so the fear of the high altitude sickness. Some are acclimatized to that and then get used to the high altitude, but they cannot work as hard as they work at sea level. So the time they can work here every day is quite limited.
How does it make you feel that this telescope is still thriving? And I know you must have some very strong feelings, some emotions about this telescope.
So for me, my entire career is with this telescope. It's kind of my child. So I will want to make take good care of the telescope.
As long as possible with the support of the local community.
We really appreciate local people here for supporting our telescope and operation. Without their support, we cannot do such good science and then provide world-class data results.
Looking to the youth of tomorrow, because you were that one kid looking through a telescope, you know, looking to the heavens, and now you're working for the Subaru telescope. What advice would you give kids that want to get into astronomy?
Science is rapidly changing or evolving. So probably our kids will see the universe in a very different way as we see the sky right now.
The Japan-owned and operated Subaru telescope doesn't just sit atop Mauna Kea. The workers are woven into the community, and as part of an outreach program, visitors are invited on regular tours of the telescope to see the inner workings of this magnificent instrument of science and to inspire the next generation of scientists.
So we just hope that a Subaru telescope will be a part of their education, and then their motivation, and then the base of their science.
Working atop such a tall mountain does come with hazards, steep and rocky terrain, the lack of oxygen, and changing weather. When we arrived for our tour of Subaru, the snow from the night before had melted, but another snowstorm was moving in. And within an hour, snow had begun to fall atop Mauna Kea. It wasn't just a light dusting. The amount of snow forced the evacuation of all the telescopes that day. All the guests and staff had to go as driving conditions became dangerous. The future of the Subaru telescope includes an upgrade to this instrument, currently in the manufacturing stages, that when installed, will track 2,400 objects in the night sky simultaneously. Installation is slated for 2022, ensuring that exploration and understanding of our heavens will continue for decades to come. And again, anyone can tour the Subaru telescope for free. Just make sure you sign up online at subarutelescope.org. Tours are done from April to November, Tuesdays and Thursdays in both Japanese and English, and it's free, so you might as well check it out. But you have to find your own way up to the summit.
So magical, and it looks so worth it.
Yeah, it's incredible what they're
doing
up there.
So high up, how high up were you?
13,700 feet.
Which is why if you do go to visit, you got to be careful, you got to be acclimated.
Yeah,
I know they ask people to stop at Pohakoloa training, which is about three quarters of the way up, kind of take a little breather, get used to the thin air.
Or you can stop by the Mauna Kea Visitor Center, which is a little bit closer to the summit. And, you know, acclimation goes anywhere from a half an hour to an hour. It just depends on your body. But, yeah, there's not a lot of oxygen compared to the surface. Yeah. So you just got to get used to it, and you can't be running around all over the place.
And I was shocked to learn during the story, I was asking you, when they call to evacuate, you mean everybody? All they don't even leave a couple of individuals behind inside each of the various telescopes?
Everyone in that situation leaves. I think there is a concern that if there's a prolonged snowstorm, say, you know, and they might need rescuing if they're stuck there for a couple of days. But at that day, all of the staff, not just from Subaru, but other telescopes had to leave as well.
Oh, awesome. Fascinating.
Yeah. Just, good thank stuff. You
thank
so
you,
Jess.
Got it.